Well, hello, friends, neighbors, John, your whiskey neighbor here, and welcome down the nook. It's Sunday, so I've got a couple of samples, and what I'm going to share with you guys today is actually the last two of eight samples that came from a Highland Park tasting that Sean Yegg Whiskey Night set up a few months back. These two from Highland Park, I think, will really illustrate cask influence on their distillate, because on this glass, I think, well, by color, I'm going to say, yeah, I've got their full volume release. Now, full volume is that only ex-bourbon casking. And then I've got their Dark Origins release. And Dark Origins is only sherry casking. So, you know, if you've got any Highland Park at all, or even better, if you've got some of the full volume or some of the Dark Origins, why don't you pour it a little bit? And when you come back, you know, I'll nose and taste and give you my thoughts for the first time on Full Volume and Dark Origins from Highland Park. 3, 4. Thanks for coming back. It's such habit to hold up a bottle for you guys to see that I've held up these two sample bottles, which just have numbers, which doesn't make any sense, but it's just pure habit. As I was saying in the opener, this was part of an awesome tasting put together by Sean, and I thought about doing these blind, but I don't have those covered Glencairns. I guess I could have used my wood ones maybe, and I doubt it'll show well here, but you can really tell the color right away between the ex-bourbon. You've got that straw gold, and the ex-sherry, now you've got deeper, you know, brass, darker notes for sure. So I would hope that I could tell the only ex-bourbon from the only ex-sherry. So I thought, you know, instead, let's just nose and sip and talk a little bit about these Highland Park releases. Now, the first one we'll talk about is full volume, the ex-bourbon. This is 47.2%, and I think this one carried an age stamp. I don't have the bottles, but I thought it carried somewhere around 17 years. So that's a pretty good age and a decent ABV. So let's see how it is on nose and palate. That's pretty sweet. Honeysuckle, some nice ripe fruits, stone fruits. Now a little more apricot, little cut pear. On the nose for me, very gentle peat. A little bit of earthy hints in there, but nothing overwhelming and not very smoky. A little bit floral. But overall, I'm left more with a sweet floral. Like I said, some apricot, some fruit cup sweetness, actually. Let's try it on the palate. Sláinte. That's quite nice. Again, good fruits, but here now a little more earthy notes, some light peat notes. Little bit kind of reminds me a little bit of was it Craigellachie that I was trying to think of? Just a little bit of not quite the fusel oil that I think of with that, but there's a little bit of something in there that's playing in that peat note. Another sip. There are a few spices came forward, more just like cracked pepper. That makes it sound hot. It's not hot. I just mean there's a bit of peppering in it to balance some of the fruit. There is a little more oak in the conversation, a couple of sips in. It's a little bit warm. I'm surprised. The nose didn't tell me that. But a few sips in, it is a little bit heaty. And especially for 17 years, I would think it would be a little more relaxed and a little more coating. but it's good. It's got a broad, I think, fruit palate, and it's got a little character. I was trying to get at with that fuel comment. It's not it really, but there's a little bit of maybe smoldery campfire, but that's a lot. There's not a lot of smolder in here, but there's a little something going on. Some older tobacco. There it is. Yeah, I can get behind that. But I mean like a lit cigar tobacco. Like, so there is a bit of that. Like, it's not that just that fresh, sweet cigar. It's more that little bit on the edge there. That's a nice dram. Yeah, I like it. So I switch over to Dark Origins. This one, I didn't really quite understand it, because on one website it talked about 80% first fill and 40% second fill sherry. But I thought I saw a picture of the bottle and it said double fill, first fill casks. So I'm not actually sure, and maybe someone can clarify for me in the comments, but clearly by the color, it's sherried. Again, I don't know if you can see it, but it is quite a bit darker. And really already just looking at it, I'm thinking, oh, there's probably some sherry influence, which of course I know there is. And it's a little bit lighter, 46.8% instead of 47.2. What you'd expect, the nose is darker. I'm getting dark raisins or fig or light prune. It's not, those are pretty heavy. So maybe it's not that thick, but I'm reminded of, you know, Christmas cake where you've got some cherries in there, you've got some spicing going on, you've got that thicker, almost brandied note. It's a little too rich for what I'm smelling, but in contrast to this, I guess I should do that. This, oh, that's a nice, really a nice light fruit note, whereas this is right away thicker, right away more sherry on the nose for me. And definitely some thick spicing and just that gives the impression of all that thickness and different style approach right away on the nose. Stride on the palate, Sancha. The palate follows the nose. It is some Christmas cake, some dark cherry, a little walnut. It's actually less heat, which I know this one is non-age stamped, so I'm expecting it to be younger. And maybe there's a little bit of that youth malt going on in sometimes get it on the edges of my tongue. That's why I'm making that motion. Perhaps, but I would mostly concentrate or suggest it, the aroma and the palate really says this is a full sherried expression and a nice one. Another sip. That one finally gave me a little bit of the smolder that I was expecting. You know, Highland Park isn't a full peated dram, but they use some of their own peated malt, and I'm getting it now in the conversation in a way that adds a nice note, a nice same kind of smoldering campfire or something that I was getting here is present, but this is really wrapped up in a lot of little bit of chocolate, a little bit of espresso, and that pudding notes. I'm gonna clear my palate and give one more quick tasting. So one quick sip and final thoughts on the full volume and then the Dark Origins. This is brighter, a little bit of citrus, lots of cut fruit. It's sweeter. It's now that I've maybe had a little more scotch, it's not as biting as I was saying earlier. It feels like a cleaner, refreshing is not quite the right term, but it does feel a little more distillate forward, and a cleaner dram. Last thoughts on the Dark Origin? Good, rich sherry, balanced with a little bit of light peat and oak. This one's a little more musty. This is a little more forward. You know, I would be hard pressed. This would be a mood choice for me in terms of which one I like more. I'm in a place where I'm drinking a fair amount of ex-sherried scotches. So this feels more familiar to me, the Dark Origins. And now the longer finish here is a bit youthful, a bit biting. I think this full volume might be a little bit nicer of a dram. But really, it's difficult to go because they're wonderful to try together to really clarify only ex-bourbon and only ex-sherry and get a sense of what your palate might be enjoying. If I was hard-pressed, I think I might pick the full volume as my favorite. I enjoyed them both. I'm super thankful that I got these samples from you, Sean. I hope you guys had a great weekend, that you're heading off into a good work week. And we'll see you again next weekend if we can find the time. Take care.